our champion, Tom Olszta of Sturbridge, faces the challenge of Brian Fuller of East Kingston, Massachusetts. Hi, everybody. Welcome once again to Candlepin Bowling. I'm Don Gillis, and just about everybody knows by now this program is on videotape. We tape it sometimes several weeks before you actually see the telecast, and we do our taping here at the fairway on Route 9 in Natick, Massachusetts. It's always three strings of candlepin bowling. Total pinfall determines our winner. He's rewarded with a handsome trophy from the Ace Trophy Company of Boston. The runner-up also receives a trophy, slightly smaller, to indicate he was a participant on our show. Now, we have guaranteed prize money of $1,150. $700 goes to the winner, $300 to the runner-up, $50 available to the winner of each string. There are lots of other ways our bowlers can get rich, and we'll tell you about that as the program goes along. We also have a certificate here for $50, a gift certificate from True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers, and that goes to the bowler with the most marks, our marksman of the day. Let's meet today's bowler, shall we? Brian?
Yeah.
Brian, I know I just asked you a few minutes ago, when did we see you last? You said it was probably a couple of years ago.
Yeah, when I was one of Tim Lipke's victims.
You, when he had his you were one of his victims, and now look who you drew today, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, you're so lucky. Now, let me talk about another member of your family, wife Kathy. She was on the show as Kathy Quinn, right?
Last year.
Yeah, how about that, huh? No, so you got a little thing going in the house, huh? Something.
Yeah, one of us has to win.
I see. You're going to try to make sure that you're
going
to try. You know this guy, of course.
Oh,
he's been rolling along here for the last 4 weeks. 400 every week. He gets in a little thing with Alfie Johnson and goes into double overtime and wins that. Knocks off three marks in a row. When are you going to slow down?
Hopefully I won't.
Try not to. I know, I'm only teasing you, but you really have been rolling along wonderfully, and of course you're top seed right now for our big show. You kind of dominate that True Value and Yellow Pages show we've had, huh?
I've been fortunate. I've been there, so just been fortunate.
Oh, come on. Okay, good luck to both of you, all right? Brian and Tommy. And we'll get underway right after this. Here's our challenger, Brian Fuller, on the line. Brian from East Kingston, Massachusetts, with a league average of 122. That's what can happen in candlepin bowling and makes it so intriguing. He came right in on the head pin. He got two. And that's why those of us who have been candlepin fans for such a long time think that this game is great. That's a 10. I got a kick out of the article in Yankee Magazine, Why Candlepins Became Celebrities. It's by John Vara. Nice article. It says, let the rest of the country assault their 10 pins. He's got two pins left. Every real New Englander knows that there is only one true form of bowling. And the television ratings prove it. Well, we're sure happy about the ratings we have. Nice shot by Brian Fuller. Brian, representing the Lafayette Lanes in Amesbury, Massachusetts. Now, Tom Olszta on the line. Tom, who has rolled for the last 4 weeks. And he starts with a half Worcester right. And that reminds me of something, just that phrase, which I'll get to in a moment. Mentioning the half Worcester, and I've told that story before. It will be an 8. But for those on the stations that have joined our network this year, once again, the phrase half Worcester, it's a punch out of either the 2-8 or the 3-9. And supposedly when a team from Worcester was facing a team from Boston, coming down as a challenge and in the very last box, needing a mark, the bowler from the Worcester team punched out either the 2-8 or the 3-9, and somebody in the audience in Boston hollered out, well, he's halfway back to Worcester now. And so the phrase half Worcester has existed in candlepin bowling. Also, of course, a lot of people don't know it, but the game of candlepin bowling was invented in Worcester, Massachusetts. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that as we go along. All right, Brian Fuller on the line now. He's working on a spare, and he gets how many? Six. The four that are there are kind of spread out, though. The object pin becomes the three. And then across the back, he has 7, 9, and 10, with a bunch of pins over on the left-hand side. He had to wait for a piece of wood to settle down. Now goes and made a good try, but left 7 and 9. Our left-hander gets set to roll the fourth. A man named John J. Moncey, M-O-N-S-E-Y, of Worcester, originated the sport of candlepin bowling. And that was back in 1892. One pin remaining here for Brian Fuller. He has another mark. That'll bring up Tom Olszta. All right, let's see now. Tom has had an 8 and a 5. Almost a strike. Yes, he has a spare. Seven. Two, 7 and 9 with wood. Made it. All right, we're going to take our first break right now. The bowlers sit down, take a little bit of a rest. We check the scoreboard for the first time. There it is at the end of four. Each bowler has a bonus ball to throw. And the score right now is Fuller 45, Olszta 40. All right, here's our challenger, Brian Fuller of East Kingston, Massachusetts, on the line. And he is working on a spare. He has a strike on his spare. Two marks in a row, now three marks in a row. Any combination of strikes or spares in the same string will establish a bonus of $50. Oh, is he going to get it? He almost had two strikes in a row. And, of course, three strikes in a row would be an additional bonus of $1,000. Three marks in a row for challenger Brian Fuller, who's putting the pressure right now in the first string on our defending champion, Tom Olszta. Tom was working on a spare, and he wound up with a 6 fill, but he's got a tough spare lead. With the 4 and 5 side by side and the 9 and 10, he was able to get the 9. Now it is a 9 box as he leaves the 5 pin. Did I say 4 and 5? 5 and 6, 9 and 10. Thank you. 1-3, 7-8-10 with two pieces of wood in back of the 1-3.
Made it. It was in slow motion, but he made it.
Brian has six, and the three pins he'll be, he has the seven pin all alone on the right. He has the 3-6.
He made it!
Before I had time to say it. The 3-6-9 plus the 7, and he made it. Four marks in a row, $100 in bonus money, and an excellent first string. He's already at 101. One pin. One pin. And again, as I said, that's one of the things that makes this game so challenging. And why strikes and spares are so much appreciated. The skill of the bowlers. A seven box. 109 through 8. Now Tom Olszta. When a bowler rolls a 400 series with us, he gets an extra bonus of $100. This man has done it 4 weeks in a row. Six is the fill. Head pin is still there. 1-6-8 and, well, now the five pin's still there. He has it now for a 10. 81. He's opposite a seven box by his challenger, Brian Fuller. One pin, the 10.
Made it.
Last week, that 10 pin cost him three marks. So that was why he was psyching himself a little before he threw that one. Line judge and referee Ralph Stewart calls time. He wants to take a check on this piece of wood, and if it stops where it is, it's going to be picked up, and it is. It was this side of the deadwood line. Brian has another one down there. He's got the 5 and 10. He's got a piece of wood at an angle to the left. It would not be surprising if he chooses to use that. He did, but he got just the 5. The 10 did not go. A strike, yes. A slow motion strike, but he got it. So he is now at 129 with two bonus balls to roll. A great challenging string by our challenger from East Kingston, New Hampshire. I think earlier I said Massachusetts, for which I apologize, because we do have an East Kingston in Massachusetts, but Brian is from East Kingston, New Hampshire. He has six so far. 135. 137. 137. Tom Olszta, right now at 91. A bonus ball to roll. Two boxes to go.
Tom has six. He has the 1, 4, 7, and 10. All but the 10. Nine. .106 for Tom. Six pins still standing. Two of them still there. So Brian Fuller has won another $50 for being the winner of the first string. Now we'll take a look at the scoreboard and find what in recent weeks has been an unfamiliar sight. That is Tom Olszta trailing in the match. But here at the end of one, the scorers are challenger Brian Fuller of East Kingston, New Hampshire, 137, and our defending champion Tom Olszta of Sturbridge, Massachusetts, 115. In the middle string, our defending champion leads it off. He's Tom Olszta of Sturbridge, Massachusetts. Tom has two pins to knock down for a spare, the 1 and the 3. He missed the 1, and you can hear the reaction. Sort of a murmur of disbelief. And he missed it again. The information I gave you about the game of Candlepin Bowling being invented in 1892 in Worcester by John J. Jack Monsey, twofold, came to me from Ray Sanborn, and I'm very grateful. We knew that Mr. Monsey had done it, but he sent me a couple of very interesting clippings which came from the Worcester Gazette of February 25th, 1948, and again the Worcester Telegram of 1952. And the reason that Ray is so interested is because in the mid-30s, he was a pin boy at the Y Alleys in Worcester, and Mr. Monsey was the manager. And when he told some folks that he had learned under the man who invented bowling, they wouldn't believe him. But. And Brian Fuller begins with a strike. He is red hot right now. First ball gets him 6, leaves 3 on the right, the 3, 6, and 10, and the 7 over on the left. He has a piece of wood between the 3 and the 6. Here he goes. Missed the 3 and did not get the 10. So it's 8 for a fill. And that for a 10. Tom Olszta. Tom down by 32 pins right now. Another beautiful spare. Both bowlers bowling so well today, and I'm sure you're enjoying it just as much as we are. We are here at the fairway in Natick, Massachusetts, on Route 9, Worcester Turnpike. Tom Olszta gets 7, and over on the right he has 3 pins in a little diamond made up of the 6, 9, and 10. So many times we've seen that spare lead that looks so easy in that little triangle. And a bowler will get two of them, but not all three. Sometimes just one of them. Brian Fuller, our challenger, knocks down everything except the kingpin. He has it to get for a spare and another mark. Ooh, just missed it on the left. Made it for a 10. Keith Williams is keeping score on that big scoreboard today. John Boyle keeping score beside me. Brian Fuller. And he gets an 8 drop. There's Ralph Stewart, our lob line judge and referee, sitting in his accustomed spot. Here's Brian now going for a spare. Makes it. All right, we're going to take a check on the scoreboard one more time here at the end of four. And after four, the score right now, of course, Brian Fuller still has a bonus ball to roll. So in what we can tell you, it is Tom Olszta 45 and Brian Fuller 48. On the line right now, our defending champion, Tom Olszta, to roll in the fifth box of the middle string. He got a break there as he came in too full on the head pin. Now he's asking that piece of wood to settle down. Right in front of the 3-6. He has 3-6-10. He was afraid of that 10. The 3 and the 6 were covered by the piece of wood. It's a 10. One and eight with two pieces of wood. Yes. So Tom has his second mark. Brian Fuller, our challenger, who put four marks together in the first string for $100 in bonus money, three to establish the bonus of 50, and then, of course, the subsequent consecutive mark, which gave him the 50 additional. Let's see what he can do with the diamond. We all know how tough this spare leave can be. It's left side diamond. 2, 4, 5, and 8. Nope, diamond wins again. Single pin, picks it up for a 10. Our challenger, Brian Fuller of East Kingston, New Hampshire, is opposite a spare by Tom Olszta. No wood to help. 2, 4, and 6. Is it going to go? Oh, the 6 pin is doing everything but falling. It is rocking all over the place. And Brian was doing all he could up here to help it with body English, but it didn't work. The 10. So, a couple of 10s. Tom Olszta has an opportunity now, perhaps, to pick up some ground. He's working on a spare, and he gets 8. He has the 6 and 7. Two pieces of wood, one in front of and one in back of the 6 and one in front of the 7. He's studying it. Let's see what he does with it. He made it! 6 and 7 with wood, and he made it. And that's how he did it. Look at it in slow motion. bonus ball. It's a slow motion strike. $50 in bonus money for Tom Olszta. Challenger Brian Fuller on the line now. Tough break for Brian. Took out just the one and the nine. Took out just two pins. It would have hurt more, of course, had that been a bonus ball. It's an eight box. Brian now has 1, 2, 7. And a piece of wood is rolling over here and getting right up against the two pin, now rolling away. Nice. He made it for a spare. Nice shot. Tom Olszta now moves to lane two here at the fairway in Natick, Massachusetts. He has three marks in a row. He has two bonus balls to roll right now on a strike that he had in the eighth. There's one of them. He has the 10 pin to work on for a spare. Made it. Tommy will admit, and did after last week when he missed three times on the 10 pin, that that is his toughest shot, the single 10 pin for the right-handed bowler. There's another big fill, a nine. He has, wood is rolling over. Nope, it didn't, it touched it, but did not knock it down. $100 in bonus money. Seven pin to pick up for another mark. He has another mark. $150 in bonus money. Already at 142 in this string. And another big nine. 151 string. $200 in bonus money. Seven is the fill for Brian Fuller. Nice shot. He didn't get the seven, but he got the other two. Brian Fuller. Another big hit for Brian Fuller. Now he has that same spare leave. Let's see how he does it as a left-hander coming cross alley on these three pins, the 6, 9, and 10. He got him. Good spare. That puts him at 119 plus what he gets on the next ball. Big hit. He got eight more pins. 127 to go with a 137. So just two pins separating our bowlers at the end of two strings. Tom Olszta, defending champion, in the lead over our challenger, Brian Fuller, 266 to 264. With just two pins separating him right now after two strings from our defending champion, Tom Olszta, here is our challenger, Brian Fuller of East Kingston, New Hampshire. Two full on the head pin for a spread eagle. One more on the left-hand side. Now he has three pins on the right, two on the left. It's a seven box for Brian Fuller. In running down our regular personnel, I did not mention, but shall now, our coordinator is Don Riley, and our producer director is Phil Rubin. Brian Fuller on the line. He has the six, then across the back the seven, eight, nine, ten. But there are three pieces of wood, and they are lying across the front. He's taking a good look at it, just stood on tiptoe to try to figure out just where am I going to place this ball so I can get all five of these. He did it! Fine shot using the wood. A spare for Brian Fuller. Now Tom Olszta. Tom came from 22 pins down to take a two-pin lead after two. He has a spread eagle. Quite a coincidence. They each starting the third with a spread eagle. Tom gets one. Tom Olszta comes up with a strike. Brian Fuller, our challenger, on the line. He's working on a spare. This is a bonus ball. He gets eight. Three and nine is what he has, and he has wood in between the three and nine. For another mark. Oh, he didn't get it. He decided to play the wood that was between the three and the nine. And he tried to use it as a sort of a backlash. Hit it on the left side, hoping that that side of the pin would go in and take out the nine, and that the pin would spin, and the other end of it would come back and knock down the three, but it didn't work. Another tough split. Four and six side by side and separated, and the seven also. Three pieces of wood over near the six. That's what he'll use. He bounced the ball off that, got the six, but the four and seven are still there. Pair of tens. Now Tom Olszta comes up. He's working on a strike. Tommy gets eight with the first ball. And a chance for a spare as he has the two and four. He has it. Two in a row. little shoelace repair here. Now he'll get ready to try to make it three in a row and establish another bonus of $50. Another spread eagle, and that gets him only the 1, 5, 8, and 9. And a tough one to convert. He took the left wing out. He took the right wing out. Up by 9 in the match right now. Tom Olszta. Brian Fuller. Two, four, seven on the left. 10 pin over on the right. Two pieces of wood in the back. Got just the two. It's a 9 box. Goes again and punches out. This time he got the 1, 8, 9 and left the 5. So almost a spread eagle. Down the middle again. It's a 5. Now Tom Olszta comes up. Five, 7, and 8. Wood across to 7 and 8. Wood sort of to the side of and in front of the 5. Did not go. Took the wood out, left it. It's an 8 box. He now leads by 8. He is opposite a 5 box. Three, 5, 6, 7, 10. All except the 10. It's a 10 box. He's up by 13 with 4 boxes to go. Now Brian Fuller comes up. No! He was going for a spare and didn't quite get it. There are still two there. And he left them there and turned around and said, "Oh, Brian, how could you do that?" I must acknowledge quickly, speaking of Worcester, from Worcester, for the 41st consecutive year, I got from Cy Topol, my old shipmate on the USS Missouri, one of the old Valentine greetings from the USS Missouri that we had printed when we were at sea back in 1945. How about that, Cy? You don't forget. 41 years. How about that? All right. Brian, right now, is faced with five pins. The object pin becomes the three. He's got the three, six, and ten on the right. Four and eight, and he got everything except the four. He's opposite that Tommy Olszta is, rather, an eight and a ten. He leads by 13 in completed frames. And he gets a spread eagle again. Took out two on the left. It's an eight, so it remains 13 pins. Eight box opposite eight box. Now he's opposite a 10. Big hit. He has a single pin to pick up the six for a spare, and he's opposite a 10. Made it. So that spare opposite 10. He leads by 13. Now, Brian Fuller, who has put on a great exhibition challenging here with a 137 and a 127 for a 264 through two, comes up for his final two. He has the 1, 3, 10, and wood in front of the 10. And the left-hander fires and doesn't quite get it. Got the 1 and 3, but the 10 didn't go. It's a 10 box. And for Brian, a disappointing so far third string with just one mark, a spare in the second, followed by a pair of tens, then a 9, 5, 8, and another pair of tens. Is he going to get a strike? No. In fact, he winds up with a 9 and 10 side by side, and no wood to help. The last piece of wood that might do it just rolled off. So he's almost destined to have to chip these down one by one for a 10. Went between them. Actually, what he was trying to do was just skin that 10 pin and have it bounce off the sidewall and hope it would come back. Now he just goes for it. So it's a 9. 96. Tom Olszta, as I said, leading by 13, plus what he'll get on this next ball. He has 7. That puts him at 95. And another spare. Pin drop, wood rolling towards the 10 pin, hitting it but not knocking it down. Now it rolls away from the 10. And he made it, $50 in bonus money more with three marks in a row. Needs a strike. He's going to be two pins shy of his fifth consecutive 400. And congratulations from Brian Fuller to Tom Olszta, who wins his fifth in a row and misses by two pins of having his fifth consecutive 400. The final score. Tom Olszta, our defending champion from Sturbridge, Massachusetts, 398. And our challenger, Brian Fuller from East Kingston, New Hampshire, 360. 758 is the total both bowlers combined. That means we'll have a winner of, but we're starting all over again with $50 here. If we have anywhere from 748 to 768 is our guess. But when I draw the card, that person is going to be rewarded anyway with these prizes.
Two cassette tapes from RCA Records. First, the latest album from America's favorite singer, Kenny Rogers. They don't make them like they used to. And from Samantha Fox, her latest album, Touch Me. And Stetson Cologne, easy to wear, hard to resist. To a man, the most comfortable fragrance. To a woman, the most compelling. And Ames Garden Shears. The Ames Eagle Anvil Style Shear is the ideal pruning tool. Its lightweight design, comfortable vinyl grips, and precision cutting blade will give you years of trouble-free performance.
Okay, 748 to 768 wins $50. Otherwise, we'll add $50 next week. Let's see. This is Pauline Stone of, why don't you put your glasses on, Don, for crying out loud, if you're going to see this thing. Here, Pauline Eaton of Seabrook, New Hampshire, and her guess is, believe it or not, 754. All right, so we have a winner. All right, Tommy, 1,100. Still there. Oh, come on over here, and Tommy, come on up here, please. Right here, Brian, please. Where I can give you your trophy from the Ace Trophy Company, and I'll give Tommy his, one as winner and one as runner-up. Let's see, Brian, 137 and a 127, great start. I won't say anything about the third string.
Yeah, didn't get the ball working.
Okay, well, listen, we have $150 in bonus money plus $300, so 450. And don't stay away too long. And don't pick Lipke and this guy to bowl against.
All right.
Tommy, another 700. You didn't hit 400 again for the fifth week in a row, missed by two pins, but you're not going to go away poor, because I have you down for $700 for winning and $300 in bonus money. Jackie Ray is your challenger next week. Bring your best bowling
along. Exciting.
Okay. Don Gillis for the whole crew. Bye-bye, everybody. See you next week.